विश्व महामारी कोविड-19 कोरोना संत्रास को अवसर में जो चाहिए त्रास को अवस्था यो अवस्था में जो लकडाउन भैर ये लकडाउन हमारा विद्यार्थी पठन पाठन बाट वंचित भैर अवस्था यो अवस्थालाई कम से कम हमारा विद्यार्थी कक्षा 10 का विद्यार्थी के यो कार्यक्रम कई सिकुन के जानने अवसर पाऊन भन्ने उद्देश्यले विशेष गरेर हमारा विद्यालय का प्र र शिक्षकहरुको अथक प्रयासबाट यो लाइव पठन पाठन सिकाई कार्यक्रम सुरु हुन गइरहेको छ। यस कार्यक्रमले हाम्रा कालिका मानव ज्ञान माध्यमिक विद्यालय मा अध्ययनरत 10 कक्षा का विद्यार्थीहरुले बढी भन्दा बढी फाइदा लिन पक्कै पनि सक्नु हुनेछ र यसलाई हाम्रा विद्वान शिक्षकहरुले यो लाइव यो श्रव्य दृश्य मार्फत पठन पाठन सिकाई गर्ने कार्यक्रम सञ्चालन गर्दै हुनुहुन्छ र यसबाट हाम्रो विद्यालयका विद्यार्थी बाबु नानीहरु मात्र नभएर नेपाल अधिराज्यकै सबैले पनि यो अवसर प्राप्त गर्ने हुँदा यो चाहिँ नि हामीले कालिका मानव ज्ञान माध्यमिक विद्यालय परिवारले एउटा राम्रो काम गरेको छ भन्ने मलाई लागेको छ र यस कार्यक्रमलाई सुरुवात गर्न खास गरेर त्यो सोच ल्याउने हाम्रो हेड सर लगायत सबै शिक्षकहरूलाई म धन्यवाद दिन चाहन्छु र यो कार्यक्रमबाट अधिकतम लाभ लिनको लागि हाम्रा विद्यार्थी बाबु नानीहरु घरमा बसेर लाइभ हेर्ने र लाइभ हेर्न नपाएका विद्यार्थी बाबु नानीहरुले युट्युब मार्फत अथवा कालिका मानव ज्ञान माविको फेसबुक मार्फत पनि यो चाहिँ हेरेर फाइदा लिन सक्नुहुनेछ र मैले यति कुरा गर्दै यो कार्यक्रमलाई एउटा उद्घाटनको रूपमा आफ्नो भनाई राख्दै यसलाई सुरुवात गर्नको निम्ति हाम्रा जुन हिसाबले लागिराख्नु भएको छ जुन चाहिँ एउटा समर्पित हिसाबले यो शिक्षालाई चाहिँ हाम्रा बाबु नानीहरूलाई दिनको निम्ति लागिराख्नु भएको छ हाम्रो हेड सर हाम्रा विद्वान सरहरू उहाँहरूलाई चाहिँ नि यो कार्यक्रम सुरु गर्नको लागि म हेड सरलाई म अनुरोध गर्छु।
धन्यवाद। सबैलाई नमस्कार। अध्यक्षज्यू सहकर्मी शिक्षक साथीहरू विशेष गरेर बुद्ध सामुदायिक टेलिभिजन जसले हामीलाई प्राविधिक सहयोग गर्नुभएको छ आज हाम्रो अध्यक्षज्यूले भने जस्तै विश्व कोविड-19 का कारणले अत्यन्तै प्रताडित छ। यो अवस्थामा हाम्रा बाबु नानीहरू शैक्षिक सत्र सुरु हुन लागिरहेको कक्षा 10 का विद्यार्थीहरू परीक्षाको तयारी गरिरहेका कक्षा 11 र 12 का विद्यार्थीहरूले नि परीक्षाको लागि तयारी गरिरहेको अवस्थामा 81 हाम्रो यो चाहिँ लकडाउनको अवस्था अथवा यो कोविड-19 का कारणले कोरोना भाइरस संक्रमणका कारणले लकडाउन गर्नुपर्ने अवस्था सिर्जना भयो र नेपाल सरकारले लकडाउन गर्यो। गरिसकेपछि हाम्रा बाबु नानीहरू सुरक्षित ढङ्गले आफ्नो घरमा नेपाल सरकारले दिएको निर्देशन अनुसार असाध्य अनुशासित ढङ्गले आफ्नो घरमा बसेर दिन व्यतीत गरिरहनु भएको छ। सम्पूर्ण विद्यार्थी भाइ बहिनीहरू र शिक्षाकर्मी तमाम जनसमुदायमा सुस्वास्थ्य स्वस्थ रहनका लागि म हार्दिक अपिल गर्दै हामी यो अवस्थामा पनि कालिका मानव ज्ञान माध्यमिक विद्यालयले आफ्ना बाबु नानीहरूलाई घरमा बसेर पनि यो लकडाउनको अवस्थामा पनि केही मात्रामा शिक्षा आर्जन गर्ने अवस्था चाहिँ के जुटाउन सकिन्छ यो विषयमा हामी धेरै मेहनत गऱ्यौँ र अन्य उपायहरू पनि हामीले अवलम्बन गरिरहेका छौँ। अन्य प्रविधि पनि प्रयोग गरेर सबै विद्यार्थीको सम्पर्कमा हामी बसिरहेका छौँ। यद्यपि त्योभन्दा प्रभावकारी ढङ्गले यो चाहिँ इन्टरनेटको पहुँचभन्दा अझ यो चाहिँ टेलिभिजनको पहुँच अलि बढी हुने टेलिभिजनको पहुँचभन्दा फेसबुक सबैको हातमा चाहिँ अहिले फेसबुक पेज मार्फत चाहिँ लाइभ जाने हुनाले त्यसबाट पनि हुन सक्ने र युट्युबबाट जहिले पनि हेर्न सकिने किसिमले हामीले यो प्राविधिक सहयोग लिएर हामीले यो कार्यक्रम सञ्चालन गर्न गइरहेका छौँ। यद्यपि अझै पनि त्यो युट्युब टेलिभिजन इन्टरनेटबाट वञ्चित भाइ बहिनीहरूलाई हामीले इमेल मागिरहेका छौँ। यहाँहरू सबैले इमेल चाहिँ हामीलाई हाम्रो विद्यालयको वेबसाइटमा अथवा आफ्नो क्लास टिचरलाई तपाईहरुले इमेल पठाउनु भयो भने तपाईहरुलाई प्रिन्टेड म्याटर पनि पुर्याउने हिसाबले सबै विद्यार्थी र सामु कमसेकम यो अवस्थामा पनि हामीले केही न केही शैक्षिक क्रियाकलापहरू सञ्चालन गर्न गइरहेका छौँ र विशेष गरेर कक्षा दस का विद्यार्थी भाई बहिनीहरुलाई टार्गेट गरेर हामीले यो कार्यक्रम सुरुवात गरिरहेका छौँ र आज पहिलो दिन हो यहाँहरूसँग हामी एकदम आग्रह गर्न चाहन्छौँ हामीले यो टेक्नोलोजी प्रयोग गरेर यस किसिमले चाहिँ नि शिक्षण क्रियाकलाप सञ्चालन गरेको यो पहिलो अनुभव हो हाम्रो हाम्रा थुप्रै त्रुटिहरू हुन सक्छन् हामीहरूले थुप्रै चाहिँ नि हामीलाई चाहिँ नि हाम्रा अनभिज्ञताका कारणले हाम्रो चाहिँ नि केही कुराहरू त्रुटि हुन सक्छन् ती त्रुटिलाई हाम्रो फेसबुक पेजमा तपाईँहरूले कमेन्ट गरेर हामीलाई सच्याउनका लागि यहाँहरूले हामीलाई सुझाव दिनुभयो भने अझै यो कार्यक्रमलाई हाम्रा सरहरूलाई सुझाव दिनुभयो भने अलि फास्ट भयो अथवा छिटो भयो भने अलि ढिलो गरिदिनका लागि धेरै ढिलो भयो लेन्दी भयो भने अलि छिटो गरिदिनका लागि कतिपय कुराहरू अझ बुझिन सकिएन अझै यहाँ चाहिँ हामीले पर्याप्त मात्रामा फाइदा लिन सकेनौँ अझ यसो गर्दाखेरि अझ फाइदा लिन सकिन्छ भन्ने हिसाबले सुझाव दिनुभयो भने त्यो सुझावलाई पनि हामीले आत्मसात गरेर भोलिका दिनहरूमा हामीले अझै परिष्कृत ढङ्गले हामीले यो चाहिँ कार्यक्रमलाई प्रभावकारी बनाउने कोसिस गर्नेछौँ र कालिका मानव ज्ञान माध्यमिक विद्यालय नेपालको एउटा प्रतिष्ठित शिक्षण संस्था हो यो शिक्षण संस्थाले आफ्ना विद्यार्थीहरूलाई मात्रै केन्द्रित गरेर शैक्षिक कार्यक्रम चलाउनु अवश्य पनि यो अपराध हुन्छ अथवा अन्याय हुन्छ त्यो हुनाले टेलिभिजनको पहुँच भएका फेसबुकको पेजमा पहुँच भएका र सम्पूर्ण चाहिँ युट्युब चाहिँ मा पनि हेर्न चाहने विद्यार्थीहरू सबै विद्यार्थीले यसको बेनिफिट प्राप्त गर्न सकुन् भन्ने उद्देश्यले हामीले यो कार्यक्रम सञ्चालन गरेका छौँ र जहाँसम्म लाग्छ विद्यार्थी भाइ बहिनीहरू तपाईँहरू जति लगनशील र अनुशासित हुनुहुन्छ त्यति मात्रामा तपाईँले एचिभमेन्ट तपाईँको शैक्षिक उपलब्धि वृद्धि हुँदै जाने कुरा हो र तपाईँले आफ्नो कक्षा शिक्षकको सम्पर्कमा रहिरहने र विभिन्न सञ्चारका माध्यमहरू प्रयोग गरेर विशेष शिक्षक कक्षा शिक्षकबाट पनि तपाईँहरूले थुप्रै चाहिँ नि घरमै बसेर पनि थुप्रै कुराहरू तपाईँहरूले प्राप्त गर्न सक्नुहुन्छ र विद्यालयले अरू योभन्दा बरु अरू कुराहरूलाई पनि हामीले सँगसँगै टेक्निकल्ली हामीले धेरै सपोर्टहरू लिएर अरू कार्यक्रम पनि हामीले सञ्चालन गर्न गइरहेका छौँ अहिले अभिभावकजीहरूलाई म अनुरोध गर्न चाहन्छु आज हामीले कक्षा दसको लागि टार्गेट गरेर यो चाहिँ नि बुद्ध सामुदायिक टेलिभिजन मार्फत यो कार्यक्रम हामीले सञ्चालन गरिरहेका छौँ र यो नियमित रूपमा शनिबार पनि यो बिदा हुँदैन र आइतबार सोमबार आइतबारदेखि शनिबारसम्म अथवा लगातार यो कार्यक्रम निरन्तर जान्छ र यसको प्रभावकारिता हेरेर बुटोल उपमहानगरपालिकाका मेयर साहबले पनि भन्नुभएको छ यसको प्रभावकारितालाई हेरेर अहिले कालिका मानव ज्ञान माविले सञ्चालन गरेको छ यो प्रभावकारी बढी हुन गयो भने अब यो बुटोल उपमहानगरपालिकाले पनि यसलाई अपनत्व लिएर यो कार्यक्रमलाई निरन्तर अगाडि बढाउने उहाँले चाहिँ एउटा उपनि दिनुभएको छ हामीलाई एउटा भनौँ न आश्वासन पनि दिनुभएको छ हामीसँग हामीले विद्यार्थीहरू घरमा बसेर एउटा चाहिँ यो लकडाउनको पिरियडमा एउटा चाहिँ भनौँ न बिनै कुनै किसिमका शैक्षिक क्रियाकलापमा भाग नलिएर हतोत्साहित हुने अवस्था सिर्जना नहोस् कमसेकम शैक्षिक क्रियाकलापमा भनौँ न व्यस्त रहेर आफ्ना चाहिँ नि गतिविधि सञ्चालन गर्न सकुन् विद्यार्थीहरूले भन्ने उद्देश्यका साथ हामीले यो गरेका छौँ र जहाँसम्म लाग्छ कालिका मानव ज्ञान माध्यमिक विद्यालयले कालिका मानव ज्ञानका माध्यमिक विद्यालयका विद्यार्थीलाई मात्रै टार्गेट गरेको छैन यसले देशभरिकै तमाम कक्षा दसमा अध्ययनरत अथवा चाहिँ कक्षा दसको तयारी गरिरहेका विद्यार्थीहरू सबैलाई फाइदा हुने किसिमले हामीले यो कार्यक्रममा आयोजना गरेका छौँ र अभिभावकजीहरूलाई मैले आग्रह गर्न चाहन्छु र अन्य क्लासको लागि प्री प्राइमेरी बाहेक प्री प्राइमेरीलाई यो श्रव्य दृश्य सामग्री त्यति उपयुक्त चाहिँ हामीले मानिरहेका छैनौँ अथवा टेक्निकल्ली भनौँ न टेक्नोलोजीको विकास गर्दै हामीले त्यसलाई पनि प्रभावकारी बनाउने कोसिस त गर्नेछौँ तर आगामी केही दिनभित्रमै हामीले फोर क्लासदेखि एट क्लाससम्मका नाइन क्लासलाई समेत पनि टार्गेट गरेर केही कक्षा सञ्चालन गरिनेछ त्यो अवधिसम्ममा नर्सरीदेखि कक्षा नाइनसम्मका अभिभावकजीहरूले आफ्ना बालबच्चालाई घरमा कमसेकम यति बेला ड्रइङ गर्न उनीहरूलाई चित्र लेख्ने अङ्ग्रेजीका ह्यान्ड राइटिङ नेपालीका चाहिँ ह्यान्ड हस्ताक्षर राम्रो बनाउनका लागि अभ्यास गराइरहनु होला कथा कविता अनि त्यसै निबन्ध जस्ता कुराहरू अध्ययन गर्न लगाउनु होला कुनै रेफरेन्स बुक राम्रा किताबहरू पढ्ने बानीको विकास गराउन लागि यहाँहरूले मेहनत गर्नुहुनेछ र आफ्ना बाबु नानीहरूलाई स्वयं समय दिएर यहाँहरूले आफ्ना कक्षा शिक्षकहरू यहाँहरूसँग जोडिएर आफ्नो चाहिँ नि क्रियाकलाप सञ्चालन गरिदिनका लागि पनि म यही आजको यो कार्यक्रम मार्फत अभिभावकजीहरूलाई म हार्दिक अनुरोध गर्दछु हाम्रो समाजप्रति को उत्तरदायित्व आफ्नो राष्ट्रप्रति को उत्तरदायित्व निर्वाह गर्नका लागि कालिका मानव ज्ञान माध्यमिक विद्यालयले यो जमर्को गरेको छ। हाम्रा काम गर्ने दौरानमा हामी अगाडि बढ्ने दौरानमा हामीले समाज यो सोशल एउटा चाहिँ भनौँ न कन्ट्रिब्युसनका लागि हामीले गर्दा केही चाहिँ योगदान गर्ने क्रममा केही त्रुटिहरू हुन सक्छन्, हामीले कयौँ चाहिँ भनौँ न गल्ती गरेका हुन सक्छौँ, हामीलाई स्वच्छ सुझाव दिएर हामीलाई चाहिँ अगाडि बढ्ने प्रेरणा यहाँहरूबाट प्राप्त हुनेछ। र सम्पूर्ण विद्यार्थीहरूले कक्षा दसको आजदेखि सुरु हुने आज हामीले अङ्ग्रेजी र नेपाली विषयको कक्षा आज हाम्रो सञ्चालन हुन्छ र भोलिदेखि हामी फेरि विज्ञान र गणित यस्तै गरेर दिनको दुईवटा पिरियडको दरले सरहरूले चाहिँ त कक्षा लिँदै जानुहुनेछ र अन्य माध्यमबाट पनि प्रयोग गरेर हाम्रा कक्षाहरू सञ्चालन हुनेछन्। भाइ बहिनीहरूलाई हामी आग्रह गर्न चाहन्छौँ यहाँहरूले यो कार्यक्रमबाट अधिकतम रूपमा फाइदा लिएर अब भनौँ करिब एक महिना भित्रमै तपाईँहरूको एसी चाहिँ सम्पन्न हुँदैछ। भनौँ न हिजो शिक्षा मन्त्रालयमा बुझाइएको चाहिँ प्रतिवेदनका आधारमा सुझावका आधारमा पनि अब चाहिँ लकडाउन खुलेको तेस्रो हप्ता तपाईँहरूको परीक्षा हुन्छ, यो समयलाई तपाईँहरूले अत्यन्तै एउटा अपर्च्युनिटीको रूपमा एउटा फाइदा लिएर यसको चाहिँ नि समयलाई सदुपयोग गरेर राम्रो तयारी गरेर यहाँहरूले परीक्षामा पूर्ण सफलता प्राप्त गर्नुहुन्छ, उच्च ग्रेड प्राप्त गरेर एउटा चाहिँ उत्कृष्ट नागरिक बन्ने हिसाबले यहाँहरू तयारी गर्नुहुनेछ। यही आशा गर्दै म अन्त्यमा बुद्ध टेलिभिजन बुद्ध सामुदायिक टेलिभिजनप्रति आभार व्यक्त गर्न चाहन्छु। यहाँहरूले हामीलाई टेक्निकल प्राविधिक साथीहरूले पुरै चाहिँ खटेर सहयोग गरिरहनु भएको छ, यसका व्यवस्थापकहरूले सहयोग गरिरहनु भएको छ र आगामी दिनमा कालिका मानव ज्ञान माध्यमिक विद्यालय र बुद्ध टेलिभिजन बुद्ध सामुदायिक टेलिभिजनको बिचमा नङ र मासुको जस्तै सम्बन्ध अगाडि बढाएर देशवासीलाई हामीले के पुर्याउन सक्छौँ, यो देशका ती कलिला मुनाहरू जुन चाहिँ भावी पुस्ताका यो देश सञ्चालन गर्ने जनशक्ति हुन्, ती जनशक्तिको लागि हामी के योगदान गर्न सक्छौँ, हामी मिलेर सहयोग गरौँ, हामीले मिलेर यो चाहिँ समाजलाई अगाडि बढौँ र यहाँहरूको सहयोग निरन्तर रहिरहनेछ भन्ने आशा गर्दै अन्त्यमा विद्यार्थी भाइ बहिनीहरू तपाईँहरूले यसबाट अधिकतम रूपमा फाइदा लिएर तपाईँहरूले बढीभन्दा बढी शिक्षक साथीहरूलाई बढी फिडब्याक दिने यसबाट तुरुन्तै हामीले प्रतिक्रिया पाउने भन्दा पनि हाम्रो फेसबुक लाइभ छ त्यसबाट तपाईँहरूले भनौँ न कमेन्ट गरेर तपाईँहरूले सुझाव दिएर हामीलाई करेक्सन हुने मौका यहाँहरूले दिनुहुनेछ भन्ने आशा राख्दै यहाँहरूले अब तुरुन्तै अब हाम्रो युवराज तिवारी अङ्ग्रेजी शिक्षकले यहाँहरूको कक्षा दसको अङ्ग्रेजी विषय पठन पाठन सुरु गर्नुहुनेछ। त्यसका लागि यहाँहरूको यो कक्षा असाध्यै प्रभावकारी र असाध्यै फलदायी हुन सकोस् यही शुभकामना दिँदै सम्पूर्णमा फेरि पनि सुस्वास्थ्य र यो चाहिँ देशको चाहिँ यो अत्यन्तै सङ्कटपूर्ण घडीमा अत्यन्तै अनुशासित भएर हामीले देशलाई अथवा सरकारले निर्देशन गरेका जुन खालका चाहिँ अनुशासन त्यही अनुशासन पालन गरेर हामीले चाहिँ आफ्नो भनौँ एउटा चाहिँ एउटा सफल नागरिकको एउटा पहिचान दिन सकौँ यही शुभकामनासहित मेरो भनाइ अन्त्य गर्छु र अब यहाँहरूले तुरुन्तै अङ्ग्रेजी विषयको कक्षा युवराज तिवारीबाट सञ्चालन हुनेछ, यहाँहरूले त्यहीँ हेर्नुहुनेछ। हस्त धन्यवाद।
बुद्ध सामुदायिक टेलिभिजन हेरिरहनुभएका सबैलाई नमस्ते। म युवराज तिवारी, कालिका मानव ज्ञान माविको इङ्ग्लिस टिचर। अहिले विश्वमा महामारीको रूपमा फैलिएका कोभिड-19 को अवधिमा हामी लकडाउनमा छौँ, आआफ्नै घरमा सुरक्षित छौँ। आशा छ सबैजनाले लकडाउनको नियमलाई पालना गरिरहनु भएको छ। यस अवधिमा कालिका मानव ज्ञान माविले बुद्ध सामुदायिक टेलिभिजनको प्राविधिक सहयोगमा आफ्ना तथा अन्य विद्यार्थीहरूलाई कक्षा 9 पास भएर 10 जानुभएका र अहिले 10 रहेर एसइईको तयारी गरिरहनुभएका भाइ बहिनीहरूलाई केही सहयोग होस् भन्ने हेतुले हामीले कक्षा सञ्चालन गर्न गइरहेका छौँ। आज मैले इङ्ग्लिसमा कक्षा 10 अङ्ग्रेजी विषयमा रिट्राइभिङ स्पेसिफिक इन्फर्मेसन फ्रम वैकेंसी अनाउंसमेंट भाई टॉपिक यहाँ आज राख गई रज म सुरू कर गए। ओके, हाम्रो टपिक चाहिँ रिट्राइभिङ स्पेसिफिक इन्फर्मेसन फ्रम रिडिङ एडभर्टिजमेन्ट टेक्स्ट, यो रिडिङ एडभर्टिजमेन्ट अन्तर्गत पर्छ। अर्थात् यो भ्याकेन्सी एनाउन्समेन्टमा भएका स्पेसिफिक इन्फर्मेसनहरू हामीले कसरी निकाल्ने, कसरी त्यो स्पेसिफिक इन्फर्मेसन को क्वेसनको एन्सरलाई हामीले कसरी एन्सर गर्ने भन्ने टेक्निकहरू म यहाँ माझ राख्न जाँदैछु। विद्यार्थी भाइ बहिनीहरूले यसलाई ध्यान दिएर हेर्नुहोला र केही त्यो हेर्दै गर्दा पढ्दै गर्दा केही अप्ठ्यारो केही क्वेसनहरू छन् भने टिपोट गर्नुहोला र टिपोट गरेपछि आफ्ना आफ्ना कक्षा शिक्षकहरूलाई फेसबुक च्याट मार्फत, हाम्रो स्कुलको वेबसाइट मार्फत, स्कुलको इमेल मार्फत आफ्ना कक्षा शिक्षकहरूलाई पछि सोध्नुहोला। हामीले फिडब्याक क्लास पनि दिन्छौँ, फिडब्याक रेस्पोन्स पनि गर्छौँ पछि। र म टपिक यसरी सुरु गर्ने गइरहेको छु। यहाँ हजुरहरूले देख्न सक्नुहुन्छ पहिलो टेक्स्टमा देखाइएको छ टिचर्स वान्टेड भनेर। ओके, हियर इज टिचर्स वान्टेड ए टपिक हेडलाइन, हियर इज भ्याकेन्सी एनाउन्समेन्ट एन्ड हियर इज अर्जेन्टली रिक्वायर्ड। ओके, इट मिन्स भ्याकेन्सी एनाउन्समेन्ट द टपिक माइट बी डिफरेन्ट, इट कम्स इन डिफरेन्ट फर्म्स एन्ड वेज, बट वी हेभ टु रिड इट भेरी डिपली एन्ड ट्राई टु फाइन्ड आउट what is the specific information this vacancy announcement is providing. Yo vacancy announcement le kasto specific information diraeko cha tyo hamle patta lagaun saknu parcha, jale garda hamle prashna ko uttar dina sajilo huncha and it will be easy for us to answer the questions. Okay, now let's read one model, let's read one model. Wanted, a renowned and prestigious English medium school in the heart of Butwal is searching for some dynamic, enthusiastic, result-oriented and energetic candidate to recruit in their institution. Okay, the school is in the center of Butwal and English medium school. It is, this school is very renowned. This school is in the need of some candidates. Those positions are vice principal, English teacher, accountant, hostel warden, you know. If you see this, one vice principal needed and the qualification, education qualification of vice principal is master in any discipline. Here, discipline means a subject, any subject, master's degree in any subject, and the experience required for vice principal is 5 years. Similarly, we can go to the next position, next post, English teacher. Three English teachers needed. You see here, everybody, three English teachers needed here. And academic qualification for English teacher is MA or MEd, perhaps in English, you know, sure it is English, in English. And the experience required for this post is 5 years. Similarly, we can see next post, accountant. One accountant needed, and the academic qualification for this post is BBS and experience 3 years. Similarly, hostel warden, one hostel warden needed. The academic qualification for the hostel warden is graduate in any discipline and experience needed for this post is 3 years. Okay, let's go to the next topic. Next item, salary. Salary is also called remuneration. Okay. Wherever we work, we get salary after every month, you know, after completing the month, we get salary. Here, this school is providing this kind of salary. The salary is as per the rule of school. Okay, the salary is as per the rule of school. Okay, now let's see the other details. Females are encouraged to apply for the post of accountant. Okay, anybody, if anybody is applying for accountant and the school is giving priority or encouraged, encouragement will be given to the female. Okay, accountant must be diploma in computer. Okay, diploma in computer is a computer course. It is a life skill, or also we can say additional qualification, or also we can say extra qualification. Okay, this is priority. The priority given will be given to the diploma in computer for the accountant. Okay, telephone inquiry is not entertained. You know, everybody, telephone inquiry is not entertained means if anybody calls to the schools and tries to ask many questions, you know, that is not entertained. We don't like that. Means this school doesn't like telephone inquiry. Means you can contact them directly. Okay. Only shortlisted candidates will be contacted for interview and tax observation. Okay. What is shortlisted? You have to understand. Shortlisted means, for example, suppose 100 candidate applied for one post. Okay, it is not possible for all 100 candidates to take interview. It takes 2-3 days. So from those 100 candidates, the school can shortlist by their certificates, bio data. They can be shortlisted to 10 candidates. 90 candidates can be removed from bio data observation and qualification. And those 10 candidates out of 100 is shortlisted. Okay, those will be, those shortlisted candidates only contacted for interview and tax observation. Okay, everybody, you have to understand. Interview and tax observation means selection process is through interview and tax observation. You have to understand. Sorry. Okay, let's see. Let's go ahead. Okay, interested candidates are requested to send their detailed resume, resume means bio data or curriculum vita, CV, copies of certificates, copies of citizenship and experience letter with a covering letter by 26 April 2020. Okay, now let's see here. What are the things to be submitted with the application? Okay. When we submit the application, other supporting documents also we have to submit. Those supporting documents are CV, one is bio data, another is copies of certificates, another is a copy of citizenship and experience letter. And those all must be with covering letter. Here, covering letter means application itself. And deadline. What is the deadline to apply? Last day to apply, that is 26 April 2020 to the following address. Okay, where to apply? What is the address to apply? You see the bottom side? The principal, Red Rose Higher Secondary School, Butwal 10, Milanchok, Rupandehi, and post box number 3654, and contact number is 98570-34953. Okay, let's move ahead. Now I'm going to tell you some specific techniques to retrieve specific information from advertisement text. Means you read the advertisement text and where is the post, where is the deadline, what is the salary, all information can be retrieved with a specific technique. Those techniques I'm going to start here. I'm going to show you that. Let's start. Okay, question number one. Means information number one, what is or are the required post? Okay, this information, how to get from the reading advertisement, how to get from the vacancy announcement reading text? Okay, now the information retrieving technique is like this. If there is one case, if there is one post, in case of one post, the answer might be the required post is an accountant. One post, that's why is used here. Okay. In case of many posts, then, okay, if there are many posts, then answer might be like this. Answer, the required posts are an accountant, an English teacher, and maybe other C, D, like that, you have to add others. Similarly, number two, how many posts are there? See this, in case of one post, the answer will be like this. There is one post, okay? Because there is one post, that's why we say one post. In case of many post, then we have to answer like this. In case of many post, there are three or four posts. Okay, let's see in this example now. Okay, What is or are the required post? What is the information? Just see this. What is the information? Okay. Required post means position, same thing. Vice principal, English teacher, accountant, hostel warden, like that. Now number two, how many posts are there? Okay, how many posts are there? Vice principal, English teacher, accountant, hostel warden. 1, 2, 3, 4. There are 4 posts. Okay, number of the post. Similarly, how many vacancies are there? Okay, if this type of information you have to get from the reading text, you have to understand one required person is equal to one vacancy. Maybe one post may be one, but vacancy may be more than one. Teacher, you can see this, you can see here. English teacher, post one, but vacancy three. Three English teachers needed. English teacher, post only one post, three vacancies, like that. Okay? Okay, if one person required, then we have to answer like this. There is one vacancy. Or if 4 persons required, then answer might be there are 4 vacancies. Similarly, question number 4, where is the employer located? Okay, located means address, maybe place. See this, the employer is located in, or maybe other thing, a plus means write the name of the place. For example, if the company or school or the campus is in Butwal, is in Kathmandu, then how to say? The employer is located in Kathmandu or in Butwal. Like that, we have to get information. Okay, let's see in the text, how many vacancies are there? So in this, okay, sample vacancy announcement text, how many vacancies are there? Then these are the number. Okay, so this is the answer we have to write down. Where is the employer located? Where is the employer located? Perhaps address comes at the downside, Butwal 10 Milanchok. See this. All right. Okay. Let's move to the next one. Number 5. Who is the employer? You know, employer means the institution or maybe person who provides the job. Okay. Who goes the or candidates who applies for the job, they are called employee. Employer, job provider, employee, job receiver. That's why that is the thing we have to understand. Okay, if this information we have to retrieve from vacancy announcement, then the technique is this. The employer is, and we have to write down the name of the company, name of the institution, name of the school, like that. For example, the employer is ABC and company. Number 6, who has advertised for this post? Maybe employer. Same. Okay, you can get like this. Okay, the name of the institution has advertised for this post. For example, if ABC in company requires some candidates, the answer will be ABC in company has advertised for this post, like this. Okay, let's see in the text. Number 5, same. Who is the employer? Can you answer? Can you see here? Who is the employer? Okay, yes, good. The principal, Red Rose English Secondary School, employer. And who has advertised for this post? Same answer. Okay, you have to understand that employer and the advertise might be same. Sometimes it may be different also. Sometimes it may be a difference. Human resource department may apply for the post for any other company. In that case, you have to understand. Okay, let's move to the next question or next information. Where to apply? Okay, where to apply? If you want to apply for any job, where to apply? Okay, if this information you want to get, okay, you have to answer like this. There are many possible answers. For example, the candidate should apply to, and then you have to write an address of the institution. For example, if you are applying to a school in which is in Butwal, then you have to write down the address of the Butwal. You have to write down the address of Butwal. Number 2, the candidate should apply to email address. For example, international job. If you are applying for a job which is in US, UK, or Canada, or maybe other in for any foreign country, you cannot apply directly by the address. Postal address, it takes long time. So there may be given email ID. So you can apply through email. You can send your scanned copies of application and other document to the email. So that's the thing you have to understand. Or sometimes the candidate should apply to the post box number. Okay, that is the postal service, post box service, also system in some countries. In that case, you have to use that as well. Okay, how to apply then? Simply, if address is given, then by post. If email is given, or you can say by email or through email. See this. If address or post box is number is given, then answer will be the candidate should apply by post. How to apply? By post. And another one, if you are applying using email, then the candidates should apply by email. You have to understand this. Okay, let's see in the text. Where to apply? Okay, here is address given here. Okay, address given here. Butol 10 Milan Chowk, post box number that, or the principal, their school name also you can write down. And how to apply? Then address is given there, that's why by post. Address is given here, that's why we have to say by post. Okay, let's go to the next one. Number 9. What is the required qualification for this post? Here, qualification means academic qualification, education qualification. Okay, if this type of information you want to get from the reading, advertisement reading text, then answer should be written like this. Or academic qualification is the answer. You have to find out in the text. Okay. What is the required additional qualification or extra qualification of the candidates? Here, additional qualification, extra qualification means what? They mean computer skill, other maybe other kind of life skill training, a language course, other maybe account package courses, any life skill courses, which may be academic qualification or may not be academic qualification, they are additional qualification or extra qualification. Okay, let's see. Let's find out, do we have this kind of information in this text or not? See this, number 9, sorry. What is the required qualification for this post? Required qualification. Can you guess where is this? Where is? Yeah, qualification. Okay, see, required qualification means anyone. Or if it is asked about vice principal, then you have to answer master in any discipline. If it is asked about English teacher, then you have to say MA or MEd. If it is asked for accountant, then you have to say BBS. If it is asked for hostel warden, then you have to say graduate in any discipline, in any subject. Okay, this information we can get through qualification. Similarly, what is the required or additional qualification or extra qualification of the candidate? Can you get anywhere? Okay, yeah, here is accountant must be diploma in computer. See this? This diploma in computer means computer course, life skill course. Okay, so this is the extra qualification here. Sorry. Okay, let's go ahead. Number 11. What is the required experience for this post? Where to get this information? Okay, and another one is, what is the offered salary? Offered salary or maybe remuneration, maybe bonus, maybe perks, anyone. Terms may be different here. Okay, where to get the first 11 number information? What is the required experience for this post? If this information you want to get, you have to see here. The candidates should have years of experience, or 2 years of experience, 3 years of experience, 5 years of experience, or maybe in cooking, in driving, in teaching. In this way, you have to find out. Similarly, number 12, what is the offered salary? If this information you have to get from the text, consider this. There are many possible answers, everybody. Dear students, you have to see this. There are many possible answers. For example, salary, the salary is negotiable. Negotiable means not fixed. Just now, not fixed, but later according to the performance of the candidate, the company, school will fix the salary. Just now, the salary is not fixed. It will be fixed later. Okay, if directly money is appointed, the salary is RS 10,000, 5,000, 20,000, 50,000, maybe. Similarly, the remuneration or salary is as per the rule of government, you know, government salary, rule of company, rule of school, rule of institution, etc. What is given in the vacancy announcement reading text, that we have to follow for this answer. Okay. Now, let's see the same vacancy announcement text and try to find out these two information. Okay. See this, number 11. What is the required experience for this post? Experience, what is given there? Position, number, qualification, experience. See this. The experience for vice principal, 5 years, English teacher, 5 years, accountant, 3 years, hostel warden, 3 years. Then this is the answer of this question. Okay. Sorry. Similarly, number 12, what is the offered salary or remuneration? Can you get anywhere? Yeah, it is here. Salary is per the rule of school. Is per the rule of school. See here. Okay. Okay, this here you can get directly money, maybe appointed, or maybe as per the rule of government, or maybe also other can be given there, or maybe negotiable also can be here. Okay, this is the answer. Similarly, let's go to the next information. What are the things to be submitted with the application? You know, when we have to apply somewhere, we have to submit application, and with application, so many other supporting documents will be submitted. Those supporting documents means things to be submitted with the application. For example, maybe a citizenship card, photocopy, and maybe biodata, maybe copies of certificates, like that. Okay. These might be the answers. Which is there, you have to copy that. CV, biodata, resume, they are same. Copies of certificates, copies of documents, or maybe testimonials. Testimonials means documents. Copy of citizenship, copy means here Xerox copy, photocopy. Maybe PP size photo or auto size photo, or maybe experience letter, or maybe contact number, okay? Other informations the company needs from the candidates. These are the things to be submitted to the application. Similarly, number 14, what is the deadline? Deadline means what? Deadline means last date to apply. Okay, deadline means last date to apply. See this. There are two possible answers. If directly date is pointed, directly date is pointed, then answer is by, before, not later than. These kind of prepositions used there, plus date. Or answer would be like this. The deadline is 25th July 2021, like this, directly write down the answer. And or other maybe the candidate should apply within 3 days, within 7 days, within 10 days, also like that given there. In that time, you have to answer, suppose the candidate should apply within 7 days is given there, then you have to answer the candidate should apply within 7 days, 7 days from the first publication date, 7 days from the first publication date, okay? Now, let's find out this information here in the text. What are the things to be submitted with the application? You can see here, maybe somewhere. Yeah, see this here. Okay, yes. Same, there are detailed resume, CV, copies of certificates, copy of citizenship and experience letter given here. See this, and this is the answer. What is the deadline? What is the deadline to apply or last date to apply? It is given here with the covering letter by 26th April 2020. This is the deadline. Okay, everybody, students, this deadline also given in within 6 days, 7 days, 10 days. This also you have to consider in other texts that may be there. You have to think about that. Let's go to the 15 number. Let's go to 15 number. Who can apply? If this information you want to get, the technique is like this. There are many possible answers. If the question is who can apply, the answers may be different according to the type of vacancy announcement text. Okay. In some vacancy announcement text, there will be given we need enthusiastic, energetic, dynamic, qualified, and self-oriented candidates, you know, and we can say this, they can apply. Enthusiastic, dynamic, energetic, qualified, self-oriented, that kind of physical features or maybe academic features focused, these persons can apply. Sometimes interested and qualified Nepali citizen can apply. Because in that reading advertisement test, this is given. That's why this is the answer. Okay. If nothing is there, only experience and qualification is given at the time, the candidate with BBS qualification or MBS qualification, MED qualification, and has got 2 years of experience, 3 years of experience can apply. This third technique also we can apply. We can write the answer in this way as well. Okay, let's go to the next one. Who are encouraged to apply? Encouragement, you know? See this. There are many possible answers. Females are encouraged to apply. Minority groups, Dalits, indigenous groups are encouraged to apply. Okay? Okay, this focuses on the inclusion in Nepal. Okay, number next. People from remote area are encouraged to apply. In some reading advertisement text, this also is written there. So, according to the type of reading advertisement text, you have to select the answers. Okay, students, let's see this information in that text. Now, who can apply? Can you find out here? Okay, see that up? Dynamic, enthusiastic, result-oriented, and energetic candidates. Okay, also you can focus qualification and experience here. Okay, these all and this all and this all. These are the possible resources to answer this. So I'm focusing on. Number 16, who are encouraged to apply? Yeah, here is given, females are encouraged to apply for the post of accountant. Only for the accountant, females are encouraged. This is the answer. Okay. Now let's move to the 17 number. How is the candidates selected? Selection process after you apply, after we apply to any post or any job, perhaps or sure that there might be some selection process. And how is the candidate selected? It means selection process. If this information you want to get, the answer is like this. The candidate is selected through interview, written test, class observation, tax observation, etc. These are the way of candidate selection. Okay. And number next, last one, whom to apply. Okay. If this information you want to get, then here comes. The candidate should apply to the manager and principal, chairperson, director, etc. Okay. Let's see how is the candidate selected. This information, where in this text? Find out. Found? Yes, you're right. Here is given a downside is interview and tax observation. This to interview and tax observation given here. This is the answer. Okay, whom to apply? What is the answer? Where is this? Yes, principal. Principal of Red Rose English Secondary School. Okay. Up to now, we discussed some techniques to find out or retrieve some specific information from the reading advertisement text. Now let's review it. Here is vacancy announcement text. Here are some points. Can we match? Post. Where is the post? Qualification. Where is qualification? Experience. Where is experience? Salary. Extra qualification. Things to be submitted with the application. Employer or employer location. Type of the school. Deadline. Selection process. Can you match? Let's see position. Where is the position? Of course, very good. Position is here. Now second qualification. Where is qualification? Very good. Qualification is here. Yes, thank you very much. Now where is experience? Yeah, very easy. It is very near. Similarly, where is salary? Yeah, very good. It's very easy. Salary is there. Similarly, extra qualification. Where is extra qualification? Yes, very good. That is diploma in computer. Things to submit. Of course, they are things to be submitted to the application. Okay. With the employer. Yes, principal of Red Rose English Secondary School. Where is the employer location? Very good. That is Butuwal Ten Milancho. And type of school? Yes, it is offside English medium school, prestigious English medium school. Deadline? Where is the deadline? Find out where is the deadline? Yes, deadline is here, 26 April 2020. And the last, selection process. Of course, interview and tax observation, it is here. Okay. Very good. You did very, very good. Okay, let's see. The original vacancy announcement, I have taken this from a newspaper cutout. This is the original vacancy announcement paper cutout. Let's compare here. If these informations are here, then you have to select. If some information may not be here, also you have to find out. Post. Yes, post is there. Is there any qualification? Yes, qualification also there. Is there experience? No, experience is not given here. Experience is given, but for the selection process only. Salary is given, will be attractive, we are told here, attractive. Now, extra qualification, it is also not here. Things to submit, also not here. Employer, yes, Oxford College of Engineering and Management, which is in Gaindakot, Nawalparasi. Okay, and now it is Nawalpur. Employer location? Yeah, Gaindakot, Nawalparasi, but it is now Nawalpur. Type of college? Yes, it is Engineering and Management College. Very good. Deadline? Okay, deadline is given the 23rd of March 2071. This is the vacancy announcement reading text of 2071, very old. Now selection process, it is given here. Selection process means good experience, preference will be given to the experience, it is given here. That is selection process. Okay. Okay. Let's go ahead. Good job. You did very nice, dear students. You did very nice. Okay. In this way, today's topic was in reading advertisement, vacancy announcement, retrieving some specific information from that. Thanks for watching. Keep watching Buddha Community Television, and also you surf website of Kalika Manavgyan Secondary School, www.kalikaschoolbtl.edu.np, or also you be in touch with your class teachers. If you have any queries, any questions, if you have any questions and queries, you can ask to your class teacher, and through class teacher, I will try to answer. Our English committee will try to answer all the questions in this regards. Thank you, everybody. And